In this video, I'm going to talk about electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. As I explained in aromaticity video, benzene and in general aromatic compound, they wouldn't like to have the addition reaction. For example, if we use Br2 with benzene, we're not going to have this product. Because we know benzene, it's aromatic, but this product is non-aromatic. So, and we know the aromatic compound, they are very stable. 150 kilojoules per mole. So the system wouldn't like to lose the aromaticity. Instead of having addition reaction, aromatic system, they prefer to have substitution reaction. Here is general reaction for electrophilic substitution reaction. I show electrophile by E positive. In the first step, double bond from benzene attack to the electrophile. So we can have either electrophile on this carbon or that carbon. I just choose one of these. So if we put electrophile on this carbon, we also have another hydrogen, of course, here. Then the other carbon doesn't have enough electrons. So it has actually 6 electrons right now. So it should be positive. So one of these carbon make a bond with electrophile. Another carbon would be positive. So this system is not aromatic anymore. And the system don't like to be in this state. It would like to regain aromaticity. Of course, this cation is not alone, so it has an anion. That anion that I just showed by B here, like a base, it can come and take this hydrogen. Then the electron for this hydrogen, it come back to the ring and make the benzene structure again. But what is the difference? In the reactant, we had hydrogen here, and right now we have electrophile. So this reaction is electrophilic aromatic substitution. And sometimes, instead of writing with base, they just write in this form. And we're gonna write here plus H plus. Let's see how we can make different type of electrophile for this reaction. Again, we know benzene and bromine, they don't react to each other. But if we use a Lewis acid catalyst, this is Lewis acid. Iron has a couple of vacant orbitals and it can play the Lewis acid role. Then we will have the reaction. So instead of hydrogen in our product, we have Br. And this hydrogen and another bromine, it produce HBr. Let's see how electrophile is formed in this reaction. Here is bromine molecule. And we know each bromine has 3 lone pair. And here is FeBr3. We can have a Lewis acid-base reaction between this bromine and iron. And then it produces Br positive plus FeBr4 anion. So this is the role of the catalyst. So whenever we use iron, it can break our molecule and produce bromine positive as an electrophile for us. Then this positive bromine, it can react with the benzene. And then at the end of reaction, this hydrogen combine with the negative bromine and produce HBr. This is the kind of mechanism for this reaction. But when we want to write the product, we just need to take hydrogen and put bromine for that structure. For chlorine, we have same reaction. All we need to do is just using chlorine here. And instead of FeBr3, we can use FeCl3, and then everything would be completely same. Then here, instead of bromine, we should have chlorine. For iodine, it is different. We need to use copper two cations as a catalyst. It is a redox reaction, and iodine oxidizes in this reaction and produce 2 I positive and copper 2 convert to 2 copper 1. Then we have I positive. This I positive can react with benzene ring. So here is an example. Then the answer is iodobenzene. We can have an O2 group as electrophile in the aromatic substitution reaction. When we use nitric acid and sulfuric acid together, it should be both of them completely concentrated. Then it can produce an O2 cation for us. Here is the mechanism for this reaction. This is the structure for nitric acid. And this is a structure for sulfuric acid. I just expand a little bit of that structure. We know both of sulfuric acid and nitric acid, they are a strong acid. But sulfuric acid is more stronger. That's the reason we're not supposed to have any water in our reaction. Otherwise, This acid, they can react with water. When we don't have any water in our reaction system, then sulfuric acid, it played the acidic role, and nitric acid played the base. This lone pair electron for OH can absorb hydrogen from sulfuric acid. So it produces this structure. Then this structure is not stable, and it removes water. I mean, this electron push and remove the water from the system. Then we have NO2 positive plus water. So then this NO2 positive can react with benzene ring. The next reaction for electrophilic aromatic substitution is reaction of benzene with mixture of sulfuric acid and sulfur trioxide. This reaction is called sulfonation reaction. And we have different type of style for showing these reagents. The name of this mixture is fuming sulfuric acid. It has also a common name called oleum. So we may see this reagent in this form having sulfuric acid and sulfur trioxide separately. We may have in this form too, H2S2O7 or H2SO4. SO3. So all of this name or this type of style, it is same thing, and it can produce a sulfonation product for us. The product for sulfonation reaction is benzene sulfonic acid. So let's see the mechanism for this reaction. So fuming sulfuric acid is mixture of SO3 and sulfuric acid. This is the structure for SO3. It can react with sulfuric acid and produce this intermediate. Then this cation can play the electrophile role and react with benzene. And the rest is the similar like the other example. But something is special about this reaction that we don't have for the other electrophilic aromatic substitution reaction. This reaction is reversible. It means if we have benzene sulfonic acid and react it with water in acidic condition, or put in another word, if we have hydrolysis reaction, it can produce benzene again for us plus sulfuric acid. There is a very important electrophilic substitution reaction for aromatic compound. It is Friedel-Crafts reaction. The Friedel-Crafts reaction is reaction between aromatic compound and alkyl halide. Or it can be acyl halide in the presence of aluminium chloride as a Lewis acid. By using the Friedel-Crafts reaction, we can have alkylation and acylation reaction. I explain the mechanism by one example. We would like to have reaction between benzene and CH3Cl in the presence of aluminium chloride. The role of aluminium chloride in this reaction is exactly like role of FeCl3 in chlorination reaction. It can remove this chlorine and produce a carbocation for us. So here is the mechanism for this reaction. Aluminium chloride is a very strong Lewis acid, and aluminium only has 6 electrons, so it has a vacant orbital. This chlorine has 3 lone pairs, so it can have a Lewis acid based reaction and produce a CH3 carbocation, and it can produce aluminum tetrachloride anion. Then this carbocation is electrophile and it can react with benzene and produce the product for us. So in our product, instead of one of the hydrogen, I'm going to put CH3. So we can make toluene from benzene by Friedel-Crafts reaction. You know, this compound has a common name, toluene. Let's have another example for acylation reaction. Again, aluminum chloride can remove this chlorine, produce CH3CO cation as aluminum tetrachloride anion. This carbocation has another resonance form, and it is a very stable carbocation. So the reaction of benzene and this cation is very clean reaction, and always we have only one product. So all we need to do for our product is removing of one of the hydrogen on benzene ring and attach COCH3 here. And the name of this product is acetophenol. It has a common name again, like toluene. Friedel-Crafts reaction has different limitation, and it's very important to know this limitation to predict the correct product. I'm going to explain the limitation of Friedel-Crafts in another video. To watching more video, please subscribe our YouTube channel.